here we are, the one before Christmas, if you see what I mean. This one is United Kingdom talk before Christmas. Do you get it? No, this is the one before Christmas. Oh, you know what I mean. Welcome along. My name's Chris Reardon. This is United Kingdom talk. Don't forget, do join us now every Monday night for our new live chat show, a whole hour long. And you can find that by going to the usual United Kingdom Talk website, unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Top left-hand corner, it says Listen Live. If you click that link on Monday nights between 6 p.m. and 8 p.m, actually, I'm on for the first hour between 6 and 7. And then my friend Ross Pats Out is on between 7 and 8. OK, once again, go to unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk, top left-hand corner, click Listen Again. No, sorry, it says Listen Live. All right, 6 till 7 p.m. on Monday nights, I am there, chatting live. You can call in on the telephone or on Skype. We can have a little chat about all things, OK? Or between 7 and 8, Ross Pats Out's there. Two very, very different programmes. He does lots of games and things like that. One of the games he plays is called What's in the Bag? And you have to guess what's in his bag. I mean, I dread to think, to be honest. Probably two cans of lager and a packet of crisps in his case. What's in your bag? That's the question. Have you got your Christmas bags sorted out even? Because I have a recommendation, boys and girls. I have purchased a compact disc. I know, when's the last time you did that? Most of my stuff, I now am download, to be honest. Or it comes from the record companies. I'm a DJ and a karaoke host. They're my paying jobs. And for my DJing, I either download music from a site called Napster. Ever so cheap. It's £5 a month now, Napster. £5 a month and you can play whatever you like. Unbelievable. How good value is that? I've been noticing, actually, with these download, the legal ones, such as Napster, iTunes, all those, there's becoming more and more of those, isn't there? And to be honest, it seems to still be getting cheaper and cheaper to actually download music legally. Plus, of course, the fact is, you're never going to get a virus from one of these sites, are you? All these people that download from LimeWire, and I've got to be honest, I used to do it years ago. I used to use a site called, not LimeWire, what was it called now? Audio Galaxy. Used to use that site. Millions of people used to download music for nothing from these sites. But quite often, you'd get a record that just wasn't quite right. There'd be a chunk of it missing, or it'd be a completely different record, or worse than that, you'd get a virus. I do believe that all these companies that are now doing legal downloads, there's so many of them now, and it actually works very well, very cheaply. You're so much safer and better off, quite apart from the fact that it's illegal to download illegally, okay? You know, you're so much better to download this stuff by paying just a small amount. It does annoy me that people seem to think that why should they pay? Why should they pay? There's so many of those people around. I could sit here and name a few. I know some of you listening and watching now. Downloading a link, don't do it anymore. You don't need to do that anymore. There's things in place now where you can download quite legally and get a perfect copy every day. I say perfect here. I mean, if you were downloading me legally, I don't think I'd be perfect, would I, eh? There's iTunes, Spotify. That's another one, isn't it? Just a small amount each week. Isn't that one run by advertising? I've not actually looked at that one. I've heard of it, though. And I believe now there's MySpace Music. Has anyone had any experiences of the MySpace Music site? How much is that one? Do let us know. The email address of the show is chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Now, there is... I have purchased a CD from a record shop. It's wonderful. The new CD from Shirley Bassey called The Performance. And I just want to play you a little snippet. I'm allowed to do this. I want to play you a little snippet of one of the tracks, track number 7 on the new performance CD, and I'm just trying to think of the title now. It goes, how long? Anyway, have a listen. Are you ready? Here she comes, just a little 1 minute snippet of Shirley Bassey's track 7 on the CD, The Performance. It's a very powerful number. Have a listen, and I will, of course, try and mime to it. Oh, don't you love that? You've got to buy that. Come on. The perfect Christmas gift. Give them the Shirley Bassey new CD called The Performance. It's an album. The Performance. I don't like to go on about it, boys and girls, but I played that first in my car on the way back from the shop and I was crying, boys and girls. Oh, there's nothing I like better than a song to cry to. I mean, if you ever invite me round to your house, never ever put a Barry Manilow album on. I will be in floods of tears and cuddling anyone and anything that happens to me close by, dear. Are you like that with music? Eh? Come on, here's a question for you. Here's a question for you. What tunes, when you hear them on the radio, have you in floods of tears? How about Lionel Ross and Dinah Ross and Lionel Richie? Endless Love. My love, there's only you. And then you start crying, don't you? Barry Manilow? Oh, Mandy. No, not so much that one. Oh, what's the name of that one? Could it be magic now? Oh now into my love. Come on, who cries and what do you cry to? Let me know. The email address, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Luther Vandross, Dance With My Father Again. Come on, let me see those tears, Chris. unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. There we are. There's my advice for some a nice little Christmas gift. If not for someone else, go on, buy yourself a copy. Here in the UK, I think it's £8.79. Not bad at all. Have you noticed how the price of CDs seems to have come down a lot? Even more. I remember before all these illegal downloads started, CDs were reaching £18-19. Now they're like £8 or £9. So in one way, I think, in that case, I think, I'm sorry, I'm just trying to do something here. So I've forgotten to start this film in the background. There we are, that's better. In some ways, the illegal downloaders have pushed the price of legal downloads down and down and down, haven't they? So in one way, I think that's a good thing. Because they were taking the mick, weren't they, some of these record companies? £20 for an album, weren't they? Do you remember? And I'm going back here, 10 or 15 years. So music is a lot cheaper now. And once again, you know, buy it legally because you get a perfect copy every time and what have you. Right, we're going to go straight onto the emails today. First of all, it's our friend Naz. Hello, Naz. In London, who says, I up lover, Naz here. I up lover? What sort of way is that to start an email to a professional radio and television video global production? Please, Naz. Now that we've seen you using your nasal trimmer on cam. Oh, yes, here it is. I've got it here. My nasal trimmer. Yeah. trimming the hairs in the nose. And the ears as well. Works in ears as well. You can do the ears. I recommend wiping it before you take it out your nose and then put it back into your ear holes. Oh, I can actually hear some little hairs being cut off there. Wonderful little device. I got this from Asda. £2.99, dear. I mean, you can't go wrong. Who can make that? It just amazes me how you can buy a little gadget like that. And, you know, for plastic, metal, there's some sort of razor blade in there. I think it came with a battery and all the electrical motor and that. For £2.99, how do they do it, boys and girls? How do they do that? Put that on there. Incidentally, I did have to remove another extra long hair earlier, which I noticed while I stood at my mirror brushing my teeth before I came in to see you today. Yes, of course I brush my teeth before I come on air. Beg pardon. There's no excuse for not being clean. Okay, some of you may not have the money to be clean, but how much does a bar of soap and water and a toothbrush and toothpaste cost? Come on. Please don't sit there listening or watching this show unshaven and unclean. I dread to think some of you are sitting there in a pair of underpants watching this programme. Or what you're getting up to with your other halves. Oh, I'm not looking now. I'm not looking. It's a family programme. But of course, if you want to send in pictures later, please feel free to do so. Chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. And I'll have a look then, after the show's finished. Back to the email. Oh yes, I had a long hair protruding from my eyebrow. And it was one of those hairs, you know, you get your two fingers on there and you pull and your fingers just keep slipping off the hair. So I'm afraid we had to get the toolbox out and a pair. Oh, hang on, I've got itchy nose now. I shouldn't have done that because I do get a bit of an itchy nose after I've been attacking it with a nasal trimmer. Just a moment. That's better. By the way, the voice is better. Did you notice? And no cough. The cough's gone again. I'm preparing for Christmas and my holiday soon to come. I had to get the toolbox out and get out the pair of metal tweezers. And I grabbed the offended hair in my eyebrow and plucked it out, boys, because I plucked it out. Perhaps I should put it on eBay. Do you think that would fetch much money? Eyebrow of Chris Reardon, a.k.a. host of UnitedKingdomTalk.co.uk. What do you reckon? Would that fetch anything? Back to Naz's very important email. He says, now that you've seen... Oh, I've read that bit. Now that we've all seen you using your nasal trimmers on cam, can we let the rest of viewers watch me perform your back crack and sack wax now seriously overdue? Oh, I hate that expression, don't you? Back, sack and crack. Oh, that's awful. Awful expression. And no, you can't. And I'm not a very hairy person. Actually, my legs are almost completely hairless. So is my chest. So is my back. And so is, you know, whatever. You are not watching me have any operations like that done. Thank you very much, Naz. Nice to hear from you, sir. But I have to turn down your kind offer of a Christmas present of a back sack and crack. No, I hate that. Please don't say that expression. I hate that. Naz also says, thank you for squirt. Oh, you can't see him at the moment. Well, let me see. Where is he? There he is. He's on the floor down there. Just a minute. Thank you for squeezing in a better view of the were-rabbit. I did notice. Well, you can't see the were-rabbit. Those of you that watch the show on YouTube have probably noticed over the last few shows, we have the Christmas decorations up, two large Christmas trees illuminated and twinkling away. We have the Christmas film playing on the video behind me. But that means my usual little things of the were-rabbit and my photographs of my family and what have you, Mum and Dad, Lee, the teapot, all have disappeared at the moment, I'm afraid, because the Christmas trees are in the way. Perhaps I could position the were-rabbit on the large Christmas tree. Will he sit on there, I wonder? Will the whole thing collapse? Let me see. Oh, yes, he does, actually. Yes, he does. The were-rabbit has been put... Oh, can you see him? Hang on a minute. One minute. I don't think you can see his pretty little face. Pretty little were-rabbit face. There we are. Okay, I think he's got a bit of green in front of him, dear. 1 minute. How long can a heart stay broken? Tell me about it, dear. Mine's been broken for years. Years! Years in many, many pieces. Will it ever be repaired? That's the question, boys and girls. Yes, Naz says, thank you for squeezing in a better view of the were-rabbit. I did notice. Well, there he is now, positioned on the tree, OK? Thank you, Naz. It's our friend Susan, the cat lover. Hello, Susan, who says, dear Chris, have you noticed, and this is on the subject of the receptionist in the doctor's surgery where I had my swine flu injection, who gave me a bit of a hard time, didn't she? Oh, you're not on the list. She was like, oh, you're not on the list. What's wrong with you? Didn't like her. Hey, Chris, have you noticed that most of the nastier people that you bump into tend to be the lowest person on the totem pole in the office or store? Yes, I have noticed this. The higher up in management or in the office tend to be a lot nicer. I think these nasty people want to show you how important they are and want to show the authority that they have over you, since they can't do that in the office. I think you're right. I think you're right, Susan. You often find this, don't you? You know, actually, most of these people will never have power. So they grasp onto what sad little power that they think they have. They really do. Being quite a bit older than you, I have reached that stage in life where I don't care what other people around me don't me think. Now, I don't know, I'm a bit like that as well. I don't care anymore. You know, I really don't. Now, I sit here doing this show, okay? Not everyone likes it. Sometimes people slag it off. I don't care. Don't care. Thank you. If you're about to write in a letter of complaint or slag this programme off, thank you for taking the time and the trouble to do such a thing. You must like it, mustn't you? Eh? And a bit like that. I mean, Susan, if you have a conversation with me, I am as I come across. I will tell you if I don't like something. However, I won't tell someone that I don't like something if I think it might upset them. For example, someone who's perhaps thinks they're a good singer, okay? And they can't sing a note. I won't tell them you can't sing a note. Absolutely not. Why would I do that? Don't want to hurt them. But if in a situation, asked, if I'm asked questions, I will answer honestly, if that's what they want. What did you think of my singing? I'm sorry, mate, you were really sharp or really flat, but you've got to ask me. I won't just come out with that. I don't say it to be nasty. I'm a bit known for speaking as I think. Susan says, even though most of the time people agree with me, what I think, here is what I do when I'm confronted with a nasty person. I get loud. I would have demanded to see the person in charge or caused a scene that would have left her quaking in her shoes. You don't mess with this lady. I would have told her that I didn't appreciate the attitude she was using towards me and told her that people deserve to be treated with respect. Believe me, she will remember me the next time she sees me. Most of the time, the attitude is abrupt, but polite. But believe me, she does not mess with me again. Liking the sound of this, Susan, I am. Next time you are confronted with someone like this, Chris, pretend you are the Queen of England and get on your high horse. Don't put up with their bad attitudes. These people only act this towards you because you allow it. Don't allow it anymore. You are as much to blame because you put up with it. You will come out of that store with a whole different attitude when you stand up for yourself. You feel like Rocky Balboa, who has just won a fight, instead of feeling bad because of someone's bad attitude. Give it a try and see. But don't go overboard and get picky over little things. Sometimes minor snubs are best just ignored. And that's from Susan. Thank you, Susan. Nice to hear from you, darling. Do you get your cats anything for Christmas, Susan? Hey, do you buy them little parcels of things? Huh? Susan also says, I hope you don't think I'm a bully. I used to be a very quiet and polite person who would never raise my voice. About 15 years ago, I worked with a co-worker who was a loudmouth and a bully. I put up with it for about 10 years before I exploded in anger one day. I couldn't believe the change in her after that. It only took standing up for myself to earn her respect. Now, I can relate to that quite well, actually, Susan. I also tend to put up with things for ages and ages and ages. And then something happens and I explode. Doesn't happen very often, okay? Once every few years, perhaps. But I do. I put up with something on and on and on, and eventually, bang, I go. It's exactly the same for me, my darling. All right, so thank you very much for that one. Hello to Wayne, not in Reading, who says, on the subject of me damaging your printer, are you sure it didn't have swine flu? Yes, sir, about 3 shows ago, I told you that I printed out an email from Wayne, not in Reading, and halfway through that email, the printer gave up the ghost. It died, I'm afraid, boys and girls. I had to replace it with another one. So I got the same make, brother, and it installed so quickly and so easily. Not like how it used to be. Do you remember buying bits and pieces to plug into your computer? And then you'd have to download drivers and do this and do that. It's not like that anymore, is it? It just works. Wonderful. By the way, has anyone got Windows 7? How are you getting on with that? Is that seamless? Is it as good as XP? Let us know. Chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Wayne says, I don't know much about brothers because I only have a sister. But if a brother printer thinks it's human, then it could get swine flu. Regarding your old toner cartridges, why not put them on eBay? Speak soon, Wayne, not in Reading. Yes, thanks for that. What I'll do is give those printer cartridges to my nephew to sell on eBay. My 12-year-old nephew, Jimmy, he likes to sell things on eBay. Oh, yes, he's a little businessman, he is. So quite often, if I'm going up there to visit, I will have a look around the house and to see what he can sell on eBay. And I usually go up with a great big carrier bag. Last time, I actually took him 2 great big carrier bags full of DVDs. And I wanted to teach the boy a little bit about business. So I took them over to him. And I was, oh, thanks, I'll sell these on eBay and all this. I said, well, I'm sure you will, but these are mine, so I want 50%. And he said, what? I said, I want 50% of the value of the DVDs that you sell. Oh, I don't know. I said, well, give them back then. I'll give them to someone else. Oh, no, that's all right. I'll do it. So he took them, right? That was in June. I haven't seen any money yet. So what's going on there? Has he not sold them? Between you and me, he doesn't watch this show, so I can tell that. Between you and me, what I intended to do was, yes, take the half of the money from him and then give it all to him back at Christmas, along with his Christmas money and present as usual. But that would have taught him, you know, do you see what I mean? It would have taught him that, yeah, well, I'm going to give you something, but you've got to give me something for them. And he would have hopefully worked out in his mind that he's got something for nothing that he will make money out of, but he will have to pay a small amount back. Do you see what I mean? That's what I wanted to teach him, but I'm afraid no money was forthcoming. So I'm going to have to remind him about that. Actually, I might do that. I might take the camera and recording stuff up there and we'll do a little half-hour show up there around the Christmas period. And I'll ask him then, in front of you all, where's my money? Shall I? Shall I do that? Naughty old Uncle Chris. Eh? Hello to Marsha. Oh, Marsha, I do wonder where you go, dear. People just disappear. You never hear from them. Marsha's in South Florida. Hi there, Chris. Hope you're doing well. I just caught your recent show where you named me as one of the show's recent deserters. Worry not, I am here. Well, I do worry, dear. I worry when people disappear. Just think of me as a phantom listener. Though I may not always have a comment to send into the show, I am always listening, sometimes at work with my earphones in, looking rather strange, laughing at my desk. Oh, are you laughing at your desk? I have, Marsha, I have a very long tickling finger. Be careful, because any moment now I'm going to creep up behind you, put my finger underneath your armpit and tickle you! Or, worse than that, while you're unsuspecting listening to the show, typing away an email, I'll come under your desk, pull your shoe up and tickle your feet. Yes! And then I'll hide your shoes. That's the sort of thing I do. I've been meaning to send in some pictures from my recent trip to Paris for your TV screen. I love the new studio setup and think the idea of rotating pictures back there is really cool. Yeah, I've asked several times people to send, if they've got any pictures to send in for the old TV screen, which is behind me on the wall. No one sent any in. What are you scared of? Eh? No one sent any little pictures in. If you've got any pictures of yourself or your family that you want to appear on the screen behind me, send them in, please. Chris at unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. One of our other friends who listens regularly to the show sent in a video of some fireworks that he took, which I've downloaded. Now, it looks all right on the computer screen. I've got to yet transfer it to the big screen at the back there. So I'll see how that goes in the new year, all right? Marsha says, since you've got so many listeners from all over the world, it would be awesome if people could send in a person from their little corner of the globe. I, for one, always love to learn a little more about different parts of the world. Well, that's what this show's all about. Sharing stories, learning about each other. Also, I heard you recently say that you're planning to come back to Florida soon. Sincerely hope to meet you when you do. Not sure what type of things you like to do while on vacation, but there's plenty to do down here between Miami, Fort Lauderdale and West Palm Beach. Plus, I am always visiting Orlando. Bye for now, and I will send those pictures soon. Send them through, Marsha. In South Florida, Chris at unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. All right. And what do I like to do on holiday? All sorts of things. I like the whole Disney thing and Great Universal, visiting places. I like to have a look around the shops. Not too keen on shopping, funnily enough. And visiting people. Quite honestly, Marsha, a little trip to a coffee shop or a tea shop would be quite fine. You know, in a mall somewhere. To have a little meeting at some point whenever I get to Florida. Don't know when that'll be. Might be next year, might be the year after. One of the two. All right? Oh, got itchy ear now. Oh, dear. Oh, my word. Right, what's the time? Oh, we've only got a couple of minutes left, haven't we? Right, there's another email here from Susan, long one. And from Robert. Robert in Iceland. Let's see. Well, we need a short email to fill in. Oh, no more short emails. Is there the other one's long? Well, here's one. Here's one from Damon. Hello, Damon, who's in Brighton, who says, hi, Chris. Came across you by accident. Most people do. I am an accident, I'm afraid. Was recommended on Facebook because we have a lot of mutual friends. Clicked on the link to the show dated Saturday the 5th of December. Found it very entertaining. Look forward to your live show. Thanks for extending my threatened request from Damon in Brighton. Yes, we're on the Facebook as well. My Facebook name is Chris Reardon UK, and it's the same on the Twitter name as well, OK? Chris Reardon UK. Join us on there for all the updates. Once again, do join us there every Monday as well for the brand new live show. Go to unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk, click Listen Live, top left-hand corner, on Monday nights from 6 p.m. UK time. Time to go. I'll see you on the next show, which will be the one before Christmas. From myself, Chris Reardon, thanks for watching and listening. Bye-bye now.